Long time no see, Hotshots. It's time for racing.
Jon's Adventure Vlog.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Jon's Adventure Vlog after a nearly month absence. Here in Braintree, Massachusetts, Riley, myself, and my fiancée are here at F1 Racing Boston to celebrate my 25th birthday. Today, February 5th, is my birthday, and we are here at F1 Boston to do some, like, indoor super go-karts. They're not just go-karts, because they go, like, 35 miles an hour. You have to sign an insurance waiver. You have to wear helmets. It's pretty intense.
You need to bring your dad here.
My dad's been here.
Oh.
Yeah, my father is actually the one who told me about this place. I'd seen like one TV commercial on like late night once, but my dad had actually been. He said it was a lot of fun, and if my dad thinks it's fun, then it usually is. Because I mean, he's a Harley Davidson rider. Like, he likes going fast. So if he thought this little place was cool, then it passes, you know, the cool inspection.
All right, so now we're inside the prep room. We're getting our jumpsuits on. We're getting ready to roll. Then we gotta put our helmets on over there.
How you doing, Riley?
Okay.
Oh, look at that. You look like a pro, dude.
I am a pro.
Laps in 5 will change from yellow to green, and a race has begun. Kart racing is a non-contact sport, and this cannot be emphasized strongly enough.
So we're ready to go out on the race. We're going to give the camera to Becca so she can film. We're ready to rock and roll here. It's going to be a lot of fun. So we just got done with our first race. Like I said, the first race is a lot of fun, but these things go really fast, and if you throttle all the way in, you honestly, you don't have a lot of control over it. I thought I was gonna like flip over a few times, but it was pretty intense. I passed Tim at one point. I did pass Riley.
At the end.
But there was this other guy, there was only three guys on the course, and the other third guy, he must have lapped us two or three times, because he was just going pedal to the metal the whole way. But here's the second course. We're getting ready to go on it now. Tricky thing is getting helmets on over these glasses, you know? Alright, so we just finished race two on the country course, and I whooped this kid's ass.
3 second lap time
faster than you. You got, your best lap time was 1928, mine was 1661. I passed you a couple times, but you're going too easy. You gotta understand, this is not your car, this is not your building. It's gonna fucking wreck. Because I was going so fast that a couple times, like, my back wheels were kicking out, and I was like, oh shit, but I'm like, wait, it's like, I'm having fun, let's keep doing it.
We got
I was whipping around those turns as fast as I could, and a few, I'm not aggressively fast. I was going just to the edge of my comfort zone.
We have one more race, so, I mean, to kick us out, kick us out.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
But hopefully you folks are enjoying the view from up top. I can't bring you with me, and I feel so bad about it, because this camera is expensive and heavy, and I can't drive if I'm holding it. We gotta get one of those helmet mount cameras. That way we can do this crazy shit and bring you guys along with us. All right, so we're done with all three races. That was an absolute blast. That was a lot of fun. I mean, it is really expensive, too. It's $10 for the license. Per person per day, and then $28 per course. But it's my birthday, so I got a freebie. But still, $30 for a 10-minute race? My top speed on the second one was 42 miles an hour. So you get up to speed. These aren't go-karts. These are like legit racing hogs. In that third race there, Riley's cart just straight up died in the middle. He had to have some guy rescue him, come out and bring him a new cart, but he's all right. He finished with a lap time of 3.5 minutes. All right, now so that I'm exhausted from just gripping the steering wheel and inhaling, you know, gas fumes on the course the last hour, it's time to have a birthday dinner at the Cheesecake Factory, so that's where we're headed next. All right, Riley, so what do you think about your experience at F1 Boston here?
It's fun. I definitely think if I had some more time to get used to it, I would have
opened it up a little.
Yeah, but the last race I did until my car died. But every turn, every lap, I felt it just get slower and slower, and I was like, no, whatever. And then all of a sudden I was like, oh, it's not going anymore.
A little bit too much junk in your trunk? That was an awful lot of fun. I'm glad I came. A good little birthday present to myself. But that does it for this episode of Jon's Adventure Vlog. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.